It's a new year. Big things are already happening. We got releases, exclusives, some juicy info coming up. So let's check them out. NCSoft is gearing up to bring PC MMORPG Aeon into Western market, yet in the mobile platform. It'll be titled Aeon Legions of War. With the original Aeon developers working on this mobile release, we can keep an eye out for an unparalleled RPG experience promising top quality visuals. Legions of War is being touted more as a strategic, narrative-driven RPG with depths of MMO-level complexities. Straying away from being one of those traditional turn-based strategy games, the mobile spin-off will let you experience auto-battles while control the timing of unleashing character skills in real-time combats. So it's a bit like a type of gameplay from King's Raid. There are over 100 heroes in the game's whole new original storyline to collect and upgrade in building your Legion. Also, key features such as PvP and guild dungeons will be included. Be sure to sign up for pre-registrations that's ongoing right now. Their official website and the global launch will be on January 24th for both iOS and Android devices. Ever wanted to play as a pair of panties? No? Anyways, the cute and super fun Panty Party is headed to Nintendo Switch this coming spring. And for those of you who don't know the game already, no, it does not contain any hentai. Get out of here, you pervs! The game features you playing as a variety of different panties battling other panties around multiple battlegrounds around the city. There really isn't a story here, just nonsense and buffoonery brought to you by a full collection of unique panties. Each panty comes with their own individual skills, so try them all and see which one fits the best. Collect them all and become the warrior of love. The game is currently available on Steam for $10, and when the Switch version releases, it will cost about 1500 yen and feature all the languages currently available on the PC version. Give it a try and let us know which panty is your favorite. As you've heard, Epic Games created their own digital game store on PC, and it was only a matter of time before it came to mobile. From an interview with Game Informer, Tim Sweeney stated that the Epic Games Store will be launching on Android sometime in 2019 with an exclusive list of curated apps. They also hope to launch on iOS during the same year. However, there is a major conflict with Apple's current policy. We doubt Apple will make a change and allow Epic the right to add their store to iOS devices, but then again, that'll be monopolizing the iOS market, right? We're no lawyer, so we can't fully speak on the legality of it, but we're hoping Apple opens the door to not only Epic, but other companies with digital marketplaces as well. Having a closed-off system has benefited them thus far, but they can probably get their title of being a trillion-dollar company again if they ease off a little. Anyways, another interesting bit is that Ubisoft decided to stop Steam in favor of the Epic Games Store for their latest AAA title, The Division 2. Seeing that Epic had no issues at all collecting titles from smaller indie developers, landing a huge title early on will definitely benefit them in the long run. I should note that this is only for the PC version of The Division 2. All other platforms are unaffected by this decision. At the moment, the Epic Games Store doesn't feature any DRM, so they are working closely with Ubisoft to get their Uplay services integrated into the platform. We're excited to see where Epic will take their platform in the coming years and how Steam, GOG, and other platforms respond to this new challenge. Also, don't forget to obtain your free game from Epic's store every 2 weeks. It's free, so why not just get it? At this point, Battleware games are a dime a dozen these days, each with unique tones and degrees of seriousness while coming to pretty much every major game. So might as well add it to the most adorable farming sim in recent memory. Stardew Valley just got a makeover by a mother. This mother who goes by the alias Ilyaki tweeted one of the most cheerful games out there with a Battle Royale mod called Battle Royale. Players will be spread around the map at the start of each round and the play zone will gradually shrink until eventually the battle is confined to a small corner of the map. You can chop trees and craft fences to use as a cover, hide behind bushes for surprise attacks, and jump on a horse to gallop away from a sticky spot. In Battle Royale, the last farmer standing wins. Still, this is the kind of thing that could take off, at which point you'll probably be able to join 100-player pixel farm fights to the death. Instructions on how to host a server where you can choose player spawn locations and loot chest placements can be found on its Nexus page. We'll provide that link in the description section. If you've tested Battle Royale already, we'd love to hear your take on it. China-based game publisher Shanghai Mobile Network Technology and developer Rampage Games recently announced Genesis for Steam, PS4, and Xbox One. Stunning graphics powered by Unreal Engine 4, Genesis is a futuristic sci-fi themed MOBA that shows off a lineup of impressively designed characters. A PvE mode is included amongst three warring factions. As of now, Genesis has been in closed beta for some time. The next phase is set to start in March. By then, we'll get to see the game's UI and optimizations for gamepads. Evidently, there's still a spacious market for mobile titles, and that gives us a big Papa Smurf grin. Genesis is looking absolutely stellar so far, and we'll keep it in our radar. And that's where we're going to end today's show. Remember, if you liked what we talked about, give us a thumbs up. If you're new here, hit that subscribe button and give that notification button some love so you're always notified when we post new content. Until next time, skip the boing.